the Church of Peace in Yakima. The history of the Church of Peace in Yakima begins with the end of the 30 Years' War, 1618 until 1648. As a result of the so-called Peace of Westphalia, signed on October 24, 1648, sustaining the principle, Humus Regio, Eius Religio, the Swedes, acting as patrons of the Protestants, made the Habsburg Emperor grant Silesian Lutherans the right to erect three churches in the provinces dependent on the monarch. They were called the Churches of Peace. As their origin is closely connected with this historical fact, two of the three built at that time have been preserved, in Yavor and in Srinisa. The Church in Rome has not been in existence since the 18th century. However, the Emperor's agreement included a great number of conditions. The new temples had to be built within a gunshot of the town walls, and they could not present what the church had built before. Moreover, they could not have towers, and the basis for their construction could be of neither brick nor stone. The beginning of the construction of the church in Yakima was formally inaugurated on September 26, 1652, by the governor of the province of Duke Juan Moshe and by General Montuarios. Lieutenant Fuente, Captain Mayer, and Engineer Bonet set up the foundation of the church. As the middle class, impoverished by the war, was not able to incur the construction costs, three emissaries were sent to northern Protestant countries with the request for help. They returned after 2 years with a total sum of $4,600. The cornerstone for the church was laid on April 24, 1652. An architect from Brunswick, Albrecht von Solich, designed the church and supervised its construction. A master carpenter, Andreas Gallagher, helped. The church in the Ross Bay was completed on September 30, 1655, and its consecration took place the fourth Sunday of Lent the same year. Christian Pope was the first priest in the new church. The church has a half-timber construction. The wooden framework is filled with mortar consisting of straw, clay, and pieces of boards. It has a shingle roof. The temple is a three-aisle construction of the basilica type. The nave, 16 meters high, 44 meters long, and 14 meters wide, has a coffered ceiling with plinthorns. Four floors of wooden galleries skirt the inside of the nave. The second and fourth floors were the first to be completed. In the mid-18th century, the first and third floor were built. The frontals of the second gallery present the pictures of 72 scenes from the New Testament, which have adequate quotations. The frontals of the fourth gallery present 71 scenes from the Old Testament. The first and third floor are both decorated with coats of arms and also with family noblemen's residences. Example, the castle of one Schweinsher family in Schwerin. The nobleman's coats of arms in the Church of Peace in Yavor depict the history of the Yavor province and commemorate such remarkable meritorious families as von Schweinitz, von Hochberg, von Wimnitz, von Jedlitz, and many others. Painter George Flagel from Kovari created most paintings in the galleries. One of the most beautiful elements of the church is a Baroque pulpit from 1617, a masterpiece by Matthäus Müller from Legnica. It has a form of a cup-shaped basket decorated with the figures of four evangelists. A wooden font from 1656 and confessions, three of them from 1683, and the fourth from a little bit later, are well worth mentioning as well. Duke's founding, one vote word, from Muskoka, was made in 1672 by Martin Schneider from Kamania, Oregon. At the beginning, the painting depicting the Last Supper occupied a central position in the altar. During the renovation of the church in 1854, it was taken into the apse. It was replaced by painting Jesus from Gethsemane by Professor Sohn from Dusseldorf. Additionally, the altar was decorated with the figures of Moses and John the Baptist. A Wroclaw master of organ, Andreas Luther, built the organ in 1855.